So the reality we now have to face is a sort of reality where every piece of software that's being distributed for free may in fact have a liability imposed upon it to pay something for patents. And that's of course assuming that the software patent system, the software patents friendly system that we have in the United States, the USPTO, is in fact applicable globally or can be imposed through treaties or whatever upon other countries, which is increasingly the case. That's what they try and do, and spread the laws of the United States to other countries. And this is inherently problematic. This is why GPL v3 was created and tried to somewhat mitigate the problem in the United States. I don't think it's a great solution to the idea. I believe in trying to abolish in software patents altogether using a different tools of trying to create opposition against the patent system and incite people against the, not against people, but against the system, and get them to speak out loudly against why software patents are so evil and should be eliminated and be against them. So what I'll do before the next part is I'll just explain very briefly that what Microsoft did today, while I record this video, it basically signed a deal to do with Android, with a company that uses Android. Instead of suing Google, it basically sued a small company that's not going to defend itself or defend Android. And it wants to make money out of Android from yet another company, which, unlike Barnes & Noble and Motorola, are not going to stand up for Linux and actually defend it in court. They're just going to pay Microsoft for it. And I received some emails from journalists asking for my comment about it. I suppose this email is like an authority on this issue of patent attacks against Linux, and that's a flattering thing. And in the next video, I'll try and explain a bit more, about what Microsoft is trying to achieve here by doing so.